Okay, we are back with more Madison Beer, Stained to Glass. Same producers, her and Big Taste, but this time we also have a One Love. Unfamiliar with who they are, but hopefully it's dope. Let's check it out. First promotional single, uh-oh. That means this should be top tier, right? The way she said left, it kind of sounded like out of key, but in a good way. Damn. Oh yeah, the shakiness, that was cool. Dude, those deep piano chords, it kind of reminded me of Jaws a little bit, you know, like it's creeping in, man. But these drums that came in, dude, I love these drums. I swear I've heard them, you know, like before. Like these aren't like any crazy new drums, but I love this style of drums, dude. Cause you'll never know what I've been through. Creeping in. Chorus sounds nice. I love what they did with the drums here. It's like a small little detail. I don't know if y'all noticed, but they put an EQ on the drums only. Not her voice, not the other instruments, but just the drums. And it sounded like it was automated. I want to hear it back. I got to hear it again. They automated it. They definitely had an EQ automated on the drums here, and it sounded like there might have been like a volume fade out as well. It just sounds like the drums are going through a tunnel. It's super cool. Like it's super cool. I love that. Whatever they did there, dude, I love that decision production wise. That's super cool. Oh! Far away, I just might break. Bro! My life's just a faded memory of one of the guitar? Listen, I've compared her to Ariana Grande, I've compared her to Lana Del Rey, and I've also kind of compared her to Billie Eilish, but whenever I would do that, I was referring to the production. But this chorus actually reminds me of Billie Eilish herself, not her brother Phineas, but this reminds me of Billie Eilish. Dude, she's encapsulating all of these great artists and combining it into her own flavor. I'm sorry, I sound kind of stuffed up right now. I have a deviated septum. My nose gets just fucked up sometimes, and it's annoying as shit. But she's encapsulating them and like blending them all together to make her own flavor, bro. And it's so cool. It's so cool. There's the drums again through the tunnel. Made of glass, but apparently it's stained. Cause you notice all the cracks, but can't look inside my pain. And if you throw another stone, then I'd stay far away. Bro. Far away. It's wild how this is like such a sad track, but there's like a, I don't want to say a contrast, because you can still have these wild instruments and sick ass drums, even though it's just, I love it. And it's not your classical sad singing track. You know, the production, it's different, and it matches the sad vibe. But I feel like if you took out her vocal and only had the instrumental, it wouldn't feel as sad. You know what I mean? But since you pair them together, it creates the whole vibe in one. I don't know. It's just a dope track. If you throw another stone, then I'd stay far away. Far away.
True.
I just might pray.
Whoa!
Hold up! Madison posted on her Instagram story in 2020 in response to a fan question. Oh, dude, wait, what's the question? Songs that inspired Stained Glass. Alive by Kid Cudi? Seriously? Dude, really? Dude. Yes, dude! That makes me so happy. Kid Cudi, if y'all don't know, y'all should know. Kid Cudi's my number one favorite artist of all time, of eternity, bro. My name, A Kid Named Brady, is inspired by Kid Cudi's mixtape, A Kid Named Cudi. And it's wild that she's saying this song was inspired by Kid Cudi's Alive. I'm feeling strange in the night. Dude, that's wild. That blows my mind. And it makes me really happy, because it's like she actually listened and, you know, other songs stuck with her other than The Pursuit of Happiness and Day and Night. You know what? Whenever, you know, someone that's not very familiar with Kid Cudi, they always know Pursuit of Happiness and Day and Night. And maybe anything recent with like Travis Scott, you know, the bigger songs that recently, but dude, Alive, dude, I don't want to say like that's an OG. I mean, it is OG, but I'm going to keep going on about Kid Cudi, man. I love that. Dude, I'm so happy I read this. Wow. That makes me really happy. That's dope. That's super dope, dude. You should stop sleeping 2 years ago. Yeah. For real though. Wow. I really enjoyed this track, man. And that little Cudi tidbit there, that's super cool to me. That's super cool. Dude, keep her duly, keep all around. Her singing was beautiful. Dude, I sound stuffed up again. Jesus Christ. But her singing was beautiful. Production was on par, above par, or is it below par? Because golfing. It was top tier. Beautiful, sad track. It kind of reminded me of Boa Duvet. Because I had like a nostalgic, a slightly nostalgic, melancholy kind of feel to it. I loved it, man. Keep or delete, keep. What will I rate this track? I want to give it a 9.5, but I want to go higher for the Kid Cudi bit since it's inspired by Alive. I'm going to do it. I don't give a fuck. It's my channel. 9.7, dude. 9.7. Super dope track. I love it.